Hi everyone, Lady Starfire here, along with Nikita, and I have a special guest who wants to remain nameless over here that's going to help us with some pendulum stuff. All right, so today what we're going to talk about is different types of readers and readings, okay? Because there's a lot of different tools that people use or that you can also use yourself. So we have a few different things here. We've got some tarot, we've got some oracle cards, regular playing cards, runes, and pendulums and some various forms of that. So part of this goes to, either if you're trying to read yourself, okay, a lot of people think pendulums are the easiest, which in some ways it is, okay. Now, here's the thing, all right. So, first of all, you have to choose your pendulum. Just like choosing a stone or anything else, not every pendulum is going to work for you, okay. So, you have to find the right one. I usually recommend people to hold it over their palm, ask it to show you its response for yes. Okay. I guess it likes me. And wait for it to stop, then ask it to show you its response for no. Okay. So this one's doing a circle for no, and it was aligned this way for yes. Now, by the same token, you can use something like this. My husband makes these for the shop, but it's a pendulum board, so it doesn't matter what its response is. When you ask the yes or no question, it's going to either go for yes, no, maybe, or I don't know. I don't know a lot of times means you need to rephrase it. Okay. Now, when getting a reading online, a lot of the, TikTok, Facebook, YouTube, different places there are readers. Okay. And if they are doing a reading with a pendulum, some are honest, some are not. So this is where my assistant, who has gotten real used to paying attention to how they do this, is going to show and explain what they're doing. Okay.
I've watched so many of them, so I've been able to see how they do it. Some of them hold it like this. Now you have to watch closely. They can use their thumbs and wiggle this way. And it can make it go forward, and you can wiggle it this way to make it go sideways. But you can make it not noticeable.
So if you're trying to fraud somebody with a reading and maybe get them to buy something or whatever, then this is another way of a fraud reading, like we talked about in a previous video.
You can hold it many different ways and be able to move it and not be seen. You do have to be careful and watch very closely.
Thank you. Great job. Now, the other issue with you trying to use a pendulum on your own is two things. One, you may be somebody that shakes. Okay. If you shake, it's not going to do anything. It's just going to like vibrate all over the place. Also, if you're asking a question, does he love me? And you just really, really want that answer to be yes, subconsciously, you will end up moving your hand ever so slightly to get that yes. Okay. This is where this comes in handy. This is something that I've made. Inside, it has a sticker at the bottom that I'm not sure if you can make it out. I think it's a little too bright, but it has yes, no, maybe, and rephrase. The advantage to this is you hang the pendulum inside. You wait for it to still itself, and you put your hands around it so that your energy is what is actually talking to it. Don't put your hands on your arms on the table where you're going to wiggle it and all that kind of stuff. Put them up here, ask your question. Okay? So these are some various ways as far as pendulums go. Now, runes, I'll tell you right on the front end, I don't read them. When I use them, it's for clarification. I have one set that I like, one book that I like, and I read it straight from the book. I'll just simply reach in, pull one, thinking about my question, or have if I'm doing a reading for someone, and you know, maybe they just want a little bit more than what the reading was, a little clarification, I'll have them draw one. And then, you know, we'll get something else out of that. There are room readers out there. Yeah. Unfortunately, I don't know how to tell you how to spot fakes other than listen to your gut on that one, because I don't read them. I'm very honest about that. Of course, there are tarot readers. Reading your own cards is difficult because, like the pendulum, if you're a pessimist, you're going to make things worse than what it is. If you are an optimist, then you're going to make it better than what it is. So it's usually best to find a legitimate reader to get a reading. anyway, there's all kinds of tarot. My issue with tarot is the fact that most decks are Aleister Crowley influenced, which means he did not believe in that unless you were a true initiate, that you deserve the knowledge. So he would leave out or change things. What he did to the tarot is he swapped swords and wands. Wands should be air, swords should be fire. Not everybody knows that unless they were trained or taught that. And so therefore that is an issue for me. I know to change it, but I see a wand on fire and I'm thinking firewood, right? So then we have things called oracle cards or fortune telling cards. There are many, many different ones. You know, this deck has little sayings on them, which are really cute, you know, and they kind of help you with different things. Once you really learn how to read them, you don't necessarily use them, but sometimes those sayings will add extra clarification, okay? Now this is something that I teach people in my classes, is how to read regular playing cards. Now this deck, it only uses 33 of the cards. These are great for people to do their own readings, because you can personalize them with, you know, choose the card that represents you, your spouse, your kids, whatever. And there is no misunderstanding as a general rule what it is, because there are specific guidelines. Each card has its own meaning. And
now that's a very intriguing thing. How about a sample read?
Oh, I don't know that one. So free. Yeah, I know. Well, that's a little difficult right now because we've got to keep our videos short and we're not done. But all right, let's just say, okay, so I'm going to say the Queen of Diamonds is for me. All right. Now, I actually have this deck programmed to read gay people.
Hey.
All right. Because, you know, and it works for, I mean, I can use it for others, but this particular deck I have that way because you have, this is, you know, the queen. Well, I have it marked as female or I have it marked as male. Because everybody, there's masculine and feminine, whether you're gay, straight, whatever, okay? But I have this one programmed that way. But let's just say the Queen of Diamonds is my card. And then I've shuffled them, you know, and then I start laying them out. Okay. And then, you know, there's a certain pattern that they get laid out. They're read across, diagonal, down, you can come over, you know, certain, or like here's a group of hearts. That means that, you know, it has to do with love and happiness. Okay. So the different groups mean certain things. There's a lot of different ways of doing it, but the cards mean certain things. This right here is no or loss. So even if you're asking a yes or no, and this card comes up, and it should be an absolute yes, if this card's in there, it makes it a no. So, I mean, it does away with a lot of the guesswork and the pessimism or optimistic, okay? So, now, besides actually having cards, okay, of course, you still need to listen to your guides even when you're reading those, not just doing it. Then we have people that are intuitive readers. You know, some people use the psychic word. I don't like it because there's too many fakes out there and they use psychic. So I try not to use that. But Nikita here is what I refer to as an intuitive reader. She doesn't use any of these props or, you know, tools. Okay. So would you like to explain to us a little bit about an intuitive reader?
Intuitive readers, we deal directly with our guides, directly from source. when you get an intuitive reading, that person, the reader, is just the best. All of your messages are coming from beyond. So it gets, some of them get really intense. But the flip side of that is when you just want, well, with me especially, when you're coming to me with something that is like very important to you, it may be somewhat mundane to my guides and to source. Say, for instance, you know, about this particular guy. I read you from the inside out. So I do my best to deliver on what you're trying to seek, but my mission, my soul mission, is to heal others from the inside out. So that's my reading style. I don't know. I mean, I know about these. I've had this tarot reading and oracle reading and all of that, but that's just not, it looks like jibber jabber to me. I cannot. I mean, I have a deck that I'm learning, but they have not led me to use it as of yet.
Well, it's like when I use my cards, I tell people on the front end, you know, you don't ask questions, ask for wisdom or guidance for your future, because my guides that are going to interpret these cards for me, you know, to give to you, they're going to tell you what you need to know, not necessarily what you want to know.
Right.
If we're lucky, you'll get both.
Right. But and for me, I'm always like, you know, I might see you in the grocery store and have a message for you. I might see the people that come in the shop. I just tell them something and go on about my business. So that's just, that's what I've been blessed with. And I am so honored that they chose me. And I hope I'm doing them an honor by serving in the capacity that I do. But all of this is, I love it all, and all of it is intriguing to me. Do I want to learn? Yeah. Do I want to use it? Maybe not. I don't know.
Maybe for you. But here's the thing. You can use a lot of these things yourself. Just be careful. And like with reading cards or even the pendulum, if you try asking the same question over and over and over, it's going to lie to you eventually, because it's already told you three times, this is how it is. And you keep reshuffling and redoing it. Then you go, okay, here. And then you walk away thinking that this is the way it is, when it's really not. They just got tired of you asking the same question over and over.
Yeah. And to do something like that with me, and I'm using one of these tools, I'm going to directly hear, oh, they won't play with it, so let's play.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, we're going to go down a rabbit hole. It's going to be funny to us, because we've already told you the answer. But just be mindful of that, because even with tools, whoever your reader is, they are connected to something higher. So don't, they may be fine with it, but they're not.
I won't just keep rereading over the same thing. This is what they said. If you don't accept that answer, you're free to go ask somebody else. You know, I mean, that's fine. You know, because I'm going to tell you what the cards and my guides tell me. So that's the only way I know how to read. It's the only way you know how to read.
I've been in some readings where my guides have actually left the room. Like, I'm done.
Yeah. Because, you know, if somebody wants to argue, oh, no, I know he's supposed to be with me. It's like, no, done told you. He's not. So anyway, all right. Well, we don't want to drag this on too long. So
we have so much more.
Yes, we do. And I hope that, you know, you got some valuable information from this, because that is our goal, is to give you information, to teach you, you know, to keep you from stepping off in the pitfalls of, you know, people out there that are there to take advantage. You know, unfortunately, our world is full of scammers and spammers.
And to make you comfortable being who you are and loving what you do and what you're drawn to. Don't feel bad about liking what you like. And if you're into the metaphysical and all that, be you. I mean, just work with it. And I hope that we're presenting personalities that comfort you and let you know that it's okay to be you. Because, hey.
It's just us. Hey, we're just us and we love you. So, all right. Do me a favor, please. Leave us some comments on what you think about what we're doing and what else you might like to see. And click the subscribe button.
Like, share, comment, call, come in. Remember, I'll text you all day for $50. I'm just kidding.
Well, obviously, you watched the other video.
Right.
And if you did, you'll understand that comment. It's all about fun, people. Have a wonderful day and blessed be.